Welcome to my projectbazaar.com. Now we discuss about the product using PSO in a spatial domain based image hiding scheme with distortion tolerance. Now we discuss the abstract for the process. With tremendous advancement in digital technology, efficient steganography technique are needed for the security and copyright protection of digital information being transmitted over the internet and for a secret data communication. However, during transmission, a stego object may be exposed to noise or compression due to which the secret data cannot be extracted correctly at the receiver end. This paper presents an efficient spatial domain based image hiding scheme using PSO, that is particles swarm optimization. Here PSO is used to find the best pixel locations in a grayscale cover image where the secret image, scale image, pixel data can be embedded. The objective function for PSO is defined in such a way that both quality and robustness of the stego image are acceptable. This result in the stego image which is not only good in quality but is also able to sustain certain noise and compression attacks during transmission. The results when compared with some recent data hiding techniques in the spatial domain show better stego image quality along with distortion tolerance. Now we discuss the flow diagram for the process. At first, the input image 1 is taken from the dataset folder, and then the input 2 image is also taken from the dataset folder. The input image 1 is act as a cover image, and the input image 2 is act as a secret image. The cover image is first splitted into one block. The sum of the block is nothing but the cover image is separated into an 4 patches. After converting the patches, the PSO optimization is undertaken for the cover image. For the second image, that is a secret image, the bitstream is calculated and the according to the optimization result, the first image and the second image was embedded. After embedding the first image and the second image, that is the cover image and the secret image, the embedded result will be a single image. The cover image only shows appearance to the user. The secret image will be embedded into the cover image. After the embedded, the encryption process is undergone. The encryption process is nothing but the hiding the data. The embedded image is encrypted using the corresponding key. This secret key is given by the user friendly. User can give any key for the encrypted image. The key must be a numerical value. After the encryption, the decryption part will be done. The decryption part is nothing but the receiver side. In the receiver side, the receiver can decrypt the image using the corresponding key. The decryption, the user can enter the key if the key is similar to the key which we have encrypted the image using the key, then the image will be decrypted. If the key is not matching to the key which we have entered during the part of the encryption, the image will not be decrypted. After the decryption, the decrypted image is shown in front of you, and then the decryption image is undergone for the retrieve. The retrieve is nothing but the retrieve the data. The data is nothing but the secret image which is embedded into the cover image is retrieved from the cover image. The secret image is retrieved from the cover image. Then the two different images are retrieved by the decryption side, otherwise the user side. Now we discuss about the initial running procedure for the process. At first, select the main.m file and right click in that file. Then select the third option, run. Now the initial GUI window was opened. In that you can see the several buttons. These are known as the push button. Then these two display units are represented as an axis. This one is the first axis and this one is the second axis. Then these boxes are represented as an edit box. Now click the button input image 1. After clicking the button input image 1, you can see the dataset folder. In the dataset folder, you can see the several dataset images. Select any one image from the dataset. After selecting the image from the dataset, the selected image is shown in the axis 1 with the title input image. Then click the button input image 2. Once again, you can select the image from the dataset folder. Again, the selected image is shown in the axis 2 with the title input image 2. After the completion of intake, you can select the or click the button pre-processing. Now the pre-processed image is shown in the axis 1 and the axis 2 with the title filtered image 1 and the filtered image 2. Here the filtering is done using the Gaussian filter. The filtering is used to remove the noise from the image. Now click the button block separation. After clicking the button block separation, the cover image is splitted into an 4 blocks, that is an 4 patches. These are the subplots which is plotted in the figure 2. Now enter the corresponding key for the encryption and click the button embed data. After clicking the button embed data, the watermarked image, that is an embedding image, is shown in the axis 1 with the title watermarked image and the encrypted image is shown in the axis 2 with the title encrypted image. Now in the part of decryption, you can again re-enter the corresponding appropriate key, then click the button decrypt. After clicking the button decrypt, the decrypted image is shown in the axis 1 with the title decrypted image. In this step, only the decryption only occurred. To extract the data from the decrypted image, click the button extract data. Now select the watermarked image which is saved in the corresponding path. After selecting the respected image from the folder, the image is shown cover, that is the cover image is shown in the axis 1 and the secret image which is embedded into the cover image is shown in the axis 2. That is an extracted watermark image. Now click the button graph. After clicking the button graph, the graph shows the range of the SSIM and the SSIM vs SSIM 2, that is then nothing but the level of the, that is the level means the value obtained by the SSIM of the first input and the second input. Then as well as the PSNR 1 and the PSNR 2 also shown in the edit box 1 and the edit box 2. Thank you.